in Islam, but it's not according to Sharia. It's according to your whims and desires. And you have no evidence, you have no dalil from Quran and Sunnah, which makes it an innovation, brothers and sisters, biskop, because in Islam we have tawqif. Tawqif is you stop, you don't do anything unless you have proof from Allah, Quran, or from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sunnah. I give you some examples on bid'ah. Some examples, inshallah, of bid'ah. Don't say bid'ah, it's bid'ah. If you want, better say the ayn. Okay. Bid'ah, it's innovation. Some people will say, oh, then the car, the motorcycle, the plane are bid'ahs. Yes, they are bid'ahs. They are innovations too, but they are very good innovations. Look, now I'm talking to you through the phone without this good invention. Because this invention is the dunya one. Don't talk to me about the dunya innovation. We are talking here on Islamic religious innovations. Because these guys, it's the most dummiest, I mean, pretext that they have against the bid'ah, okay? And concerning the dunya bid'ah, they are good. They are good for us. Look, we are using the phone, we are using the mic, etc. to deliver the message. But the bid'ah in Islam, which is you add from Islam, which is not something that is not from it. For example, I give you some examples. Someone will say, I will fast and stand in the sun. This is bid'ah because no one did it before you. Khair ya Amir, bilihyatik. Ameen, alhamdulillah. Adhan, for example, for the Salatul Eid. There is no adhan for the Salatul Eid. If someone makes adhan, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, for Salatul Eid, there is no adhan for Salatul Eid. If someone does it, this is bid'ah. Mawlid, Christmas of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, bid'ah. No sahabi did it. Reading Quran collectively with one intonation. Bid'ah, no sahabi did it. Everyone has to read on his own. Making the adhkar in the feast of Eid in the masjid collectively together. Bid'ah, no sahabi did it. Because you are now accusing the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he didn't bring us this way. Thus, you are accusing the Prophet that he didn't bring us this way. That you are claiming that you are better than the Prophet. You are not. The Sahabi ibn Mas'ud said to someone, now you are making the Allahu Akbar, there is one above them, he found one leader in the masjid, they are making invocations, they are halqas, circles, each circle they have a leader, and the leader they have stones, 100 stones, he said, now takbir, Allahu Akbar, they do it together, he said, and Ibn Mas'ud went to them. And also Umar did that. He said, now you have two things. Either you are better than the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, or you are on a way, or you are misled. So choose. They said, we are misled. Then, because if Prophet didn't do this, the tasbih, you do it with your fingers, not even with the beads. The beads are for someone who has Zahaimer, he does not memorize. All right, 33 here. Subhanallah, subhanallah, subhanallah. Subhanallah twice, subhanallah, this is 6, and here another 6, and you finish with 1, subhanallah, here this is 33. So communal or collective dhikr invocations are bid'ah. Why? Because it's something unprecedented, not done in the time of Sahaba. Always ask, did the Sahaba, the Prophet and the Sahaba, did it or not? If they did it, do it. If not, stop, refrain, abstain. Because it's that's what we call bid'ah. Something unprecedented, not done by the Prophet and the direct students of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You are not better than them. You are not better than them. You cannot bring... Imam Malik said, if someone wants to, or Ibn Mas'ud, he said, if someone wants to follow a path, he follows the path of the pious predecessors because we are not better than them. In Islam, of course, not talking on dunya. So this innovated the adhkar are bid'ah. Why? And even Sadaqallahu al-Azim, some guys, they read Quran and then they say Sadaqallahu al-Azim with some kind of intonations and, you know, they feel it. And at the same time, that's bid'ah because Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam didn't do it. Jumu'ah Mubarak, Saturday Mubarak, today, Thursday Mubarak. Each Thursday you say Thursday Mubarak, Jumu'ah Mubarak, until when you say to someone, no, don't say it, you say that, this is a munkar. No, we say, who said it? No sahabi said it. So there is no bid'ah hasana in Islam. There is no good bid'ah or bad bid'ah because Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, every innovation is bid'ah and every bid'ah is in hell. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. when he said, whoever starts something good, he will have the reward of it, and those who do it with him. When he said this after the Sahaba gave charity. So charity is already rooted in Islam. Religion of Islam is not lacking, it's complete. The religion of Islam is complete, and Allah perfected it, as he said in Surah Al-Ma'idah. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, today we have perfected your Islam. There is no room for improvement. And if you do, you contradict the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this day I have perfected your religion for you, completed my favor upon you, and have chosen for you Islam. Have chosen for you Islam as religion. So you have no space for invention, for innovation. The innovators are accusing Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he is guilty, astaghfirullah, not to deliver for us this or that or any ritual that they add in Islam. And by this, they commit shirk and they commit kufr. Shirk because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَمْ لَهُمْ شُرَكَاءَ شَرَعَهُ لَهُمْ مِنَ الدِّينِ مَا لَمْ يَأْذَنْ بِهِ اللَّهِ. Or else they have associators or partners apart from Allah. They legislate for them what Allah has not ordained. And also, bid'ah is shirk and bid'ah is kufr. If you think that Prophet, you are better than the Prophet because Prophet didn't do this, and you do it. And you say intention. Intention is not alone, brothers and sisters. Intention is not alone. Why? Because there are two conditions if you want Allah to accept from you any good deed. Khalis and sawaba, sincere, and you do it as a righteous deed, a compatible to what Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did or ordained. Is there any, or are there any proofs that bid'ah, this innovation in Islam, that your innovation is something you add in Islam that is not from it? Are there any proofs that bid'ah is prohibited? Yes. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the hadith says in a hadith narrated by Aisha, whoever adds in Islam what is not from it is rejected upon his face. Never add anything in Islam. Because if you open the door, anyone will add something, then you will change Islam. There is no editing to Islam because the legislator is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now,